Hello and welcome, I'm the Eaten Man, and this is Medieval Mod Mondays. Today we're going to be taking a look at my number one favorite mod of all time, Divide and Conquer. Divide and Conquer version 1, Third Age Total War, really. It's fantastic. I absolutely love this mod. This is my number one mod of all time. I absolutely love this mod. Did I tell you that I love this mod? So we're gonna be going into a battle. I didn't mean to actually start it, but I guess that doesn't matter. It is a custom battle with the four most prominent factions: Gondor for the men, for the humans, for mankind, Mordor for the orcs, Dwarves of Erebor for the dwarves, obviously, and Realm of Imladris for the elves. Now, each of these factions, like, there's obviously four races, really, in this mod. But there's so many nice factions, and each faction is so dynamically different. It really is. Like, obviously, there's some men factions that are kind of the same, because all men, or even with the dwarves, they're all kind of the same faction, or with elves, they're all kind of the same faction, but they're still so fantastic that I absolutely love these. I just absolutely love this mod. Okay? I do. So I'm gonna get these guys into some units, and I'm gonna show you them. Some of these models are absolutely beautiful. Again, I just totally love this mod. I really do. This is one of the best mods I have ever played. It is the best mod ever. I absolutely love it. I'm not the most organized of people, but it is okay. Okay, so let's take a look at Gondor for just a second. They're some really, really nice models. Very, very shiny. These are more Dol Amroth with the white swan, but very shiny units. Nice shield wall. I like the shield wall, how it's implemented in this mod. I like the Gondorian spearmen. This is very beautiful. Very, very nice looking units. Very solid and able to hold quite well. Some Minas Ithil guardsmen. They're nice pointy spears poking out of their shields. Behind them with some guards of Osgiliath. Let's actually put them into guard mode for just a second. No, they won't do anything. Okay, never mind. But some Fountain Guard with their nice swan helmets. Very, very nice looking unit. Some Tharbad Royal Guards. Also a really great looking unit. A little boring, but still really cool. And Guards of Osgiliath. Very, very nice with their shiny chainmail. Behind them, some Talon Knights. These are totally Dol Amroth units, but they're really, really epic looking. Swan helmets, swan shields. They look like they can kick some butt. We hear some Citadel Guard. Some little in the middle between common and not common. They're Citadel Guards. They'll kick some butt. Some Wardens of the White Tower. These are obviously Gondorian units. Even though with the little swan helmets. Very beautiful looking unit as well. Some Ithil Rangers right behind them. Snake Eye. Nice Ithilian Rangers. Faramir and the sort. Some Tirith Air Marksmen. Pretty much the Talon Knights, except archers and a little less armor. But I like the model. Really nice model. Gondorian Cav. Some of the... Just that's what you get. Gondorian Cav. And some Dor and Ernil. These are, again, Dol Amroth As you can see by the shields, like the swan, that's the Dalai Moth's whole thing is swan, but really nice looking unit. Could probably pack a punch. I haven't actually played as Gondor really before, but anyways, that's kind of the men. Very, again, very beautiful units, very organized, clean. I like them. Over here, we are the Dwarves of Erebor. Now, I use many, many different units for this one, just because there are so many unique units for the Dwarves. They have so many unique units. So great. I think these guys are Vault Wardens. Very, very sturdy unit of Pikemen. Very nice models on these guys. Very sturdy in a fight. Over here, we have some King's Halberds. Very nice unit as well. A little less of the coolness factor, but very sturdy. Indeed, you can always guess, well, you can always rely on your dwarves to be very, very sturdy. A very, very sturdy faction. As Gondor and usually all men factions are a little more versatile. As Gondor is more of a kind of a roam, where they have their solid blocks of infantry with supporting cav and supporting the Elite Rangers, but able to do a little more flexible, I guess I should say. While the dwarves, they're more sturdy and better at fighting just 1v1 and not all around the battlefield. Some now into the unique and so beautiful units. This is why I really love this mod. Just look at these fantastic units. The Orakarni nobles. Not that I can actually pronounce it correctly. Okay, I can do it with it. With their giant mallets and their pink armor. Look at them. They look so amazing with their red capes. Love this unit. Some Axes of Erebor with their giant axes above their heads. They look like they can take on trolls 1v1. Some Khazad-dûm guardians with their beautiful golden face masks. And again, really beautiful units. Really beautiful individual units for the dwarves. They're so fantastic. Some Iron Guard. Some sturdy, heavy infantry. These will be your, like, elites and whatnot. I think these are Hammers of Gundabad. Really sturdy hammers with their tanky appearance. Well, all dwarves look tanky. These guys are the tanks. They're like the Orokarni nobles, except with flat helmets. But still, really beautiful units. I don't know what these are, just because I don't remember the name. But these are also look really good-looking units. Really detailed. I love all of these units. I'm just going to keep on saying it. These are your... I know, these are just Dwarven Axemen. Just normal dwarves. Oh, these guys. I don't remember what half of these guys are. These guys are the Sons of the Fallen. These are like... really... Oh, just look at that shield wall. Just look at it. Just the symmetry. Perfect symmetry. It gives you this nice feeling. It's beautiful. Oh, so beautiful. So beautiful. Don't remember what these guys are, but they're also really nice looking with their spears. And although it's very, very strange to see a dwarf with just a plain old spear, pikes is different, but spears is kind of weird to see. And these guys, they're just malleteers. I don't know how you'd pronounce them, but they are pretty much the dwarven warriors of Erebor. So pretty nice unit. Although the mallet kind of clips through the helmet, so that's kind of weird, but I like the beard guard. Over here, these are the Dragon Slayers. Fully decked out, ready to take on a fight a dragon with their beautiful large shields, blocking the flames, and then their killer axes, ready to go through a dragon scale. Very nice unit. Very elite unit. Like, elitist of the elite unit. As well as the Sons of the Fallen. Both of these are super elite units. And some engineers. Blackfoot engineers, I think it is. They're pretty much Sons of the Fallen. Or dragon slayers with crossbows, with killer crossbows. So those are the dwarves. Very, very sturdy. Very sturdy faction. Very nice faction. Now onto the Realm of Imladris. These are some normal sword Quendi. They're basic infantry who can, for basic infantry, they could take on a lot of basic infantry. Sure, they'll get wrecked by elite tier units, but they'll give elite tier units a run for their money. Over here, some again, I don't know the name because with this mod, well, with Medieval 2 in general, you got to be really close to tell what they are. So I don't know the names. Mithland nobles, I think. A very nice unit. I haven't actually used them yet, but they're elves. Obviously, they're great. Some Imladris Guard. I've used these guys. Very, very good for holding a choke point. And now we're into the nice golden units of the elves. I cannot pronounce their name. That's why I'm not going to try. But very, very nice with their spears. And over here, the ones with their two-handed swords. Nice golden plated armor. I don't actually think it's gold, but it looks like gold, so I'm going to say it's gold. Some Smiths of Aurigion. This unit, okay. Just going to say, this unit is the best unit of any unit. These are the best units in this game. Best unit ever. Absolute best unit. Absolute favorite unit. These guys are fantastic. I love them so much. They can chew through even dwarves with relative ease. Ah, oh, they're so amazing. Some more. I think these are also nobles. I don't know. These are Tulka's faithful. One of your early, more elite troops. Really great unit. Fantastic unit. Some archers ready to take on the enemy. The archers for the elves are the best, well, obviously they're the best archers in the game, able to take down whole units before they even reach their lines. And some Imladris Riders right here. I remember this name because it's a very, very simple name. Imladris Riders, who's going to forget that name? So, elves, very fast, very shiny, very, very strong. Better as shock units, though. You don't, in the campaign, they're super expensive, and you don't want to stay in prolonged combat too much. You kind of want to get the combat over with. So if you're fighting orcs, that's a great thing, because you can just destroy the morale, make them all rout, try to lose as little as possible, because every elf life is, like, worth 20, 30 orcs. So you want to make them count. Now, so we've seen the three good factions, sort of. Like, obviously, there are bad men, and I don't even know if there's bad orcs or bad elves, really. No, bad elves, really. So Gondor, flexible. It's a human faction. Okay, that's really all you can say about it. Dwarves, slow, sturdy, hardy, very, very, very armored. Elves, fast, expensive as all heck, just really great, really great, really strong. And now, Mordor, with their really diverse, it's really diverse, because they have so many, like, they can get so many mercenaries and whatnot, so it's a really great faction. If you like hordes upon hordes upon hordes of enemy of soldiers ready to crush your enemies, they have some really cool units like these guys, great beasts of Mordor, ready to do quite a lot of damage rampaging through your troops. A few well-placed javelin shots will take them down, but very, very difficult to do so in melee combat. Some black Numenoreans. These guys are the general bodyguard, and they are difficult to take down. They're pretty much elven tier cav. Now, elves are the best. These guys are the same tier as that. Very, very difficult to take down. Some orc archers with their dirty, rusty, falling apart armor. Very, very nice. Some black Numenorean bows. So, those guys on horse, but with bows. So, they can take down quite a few men before they reach. One of the key units of Mordor is the Ulag Hai armored trolls created in Mordor itself. Very, very dangerous. Very, very scary. You'll want to take them down with catapults, ballistas, whatever you can do. Try not to fight these guys. And if you're using them, get them into the middle of combat. Get them surrounded. Whatever you have to do, because they will stand for quite a long time. They're very, very fantastic shock troops. Trolls, they're pretty much... They're really good units. Really, really good units. Although they're unarmored, so a few well-placed arrows will take down a troll. I've had it where trolls are charging and, like... Trolls are charging at, say, archers. The archers fire at them, and a couple trolls will go down. Very unarmored, but very, very good shock troops. Very good shock troops. Some Uruk halberds, they're orcs. So they're kind of crappy, but still good for orcs. They're a basic unit. They're the ones that you send in first, really. Some more Uruk halberdiers. Some Morgul Chosen. These are more of your elite troops with their giant shield, skull shields and their sickles and bills and their nice spears. Behind them is Sauron's Will, another shock troop for a shock unit, I should say. It's not like the trolls where it's, you know, a few, but like Sauron's Will is dangerous and will even tear apart elven units. Obviously not the highest tier, but still very, very, very dangerous. So, yes, we're not going to see him go into battle, just because I want to show you the campaign map. But I may show you one beautiful, beautiful shot of something absolutely beautiful. Alright, so I'll see you later. Alright, so I'm just going to show you a little something small. But something really, really, really cool. What it is what I was talking about, how the trolls, super good, super, very, very good. Actually, pretty fast. They can keep up with some fairly good cav. But what I was saying is that how trolls, especially these mountain trolls, how while really, really strong, have low armor. So I have a couple unit of Elder Council. These are some of the more elite units of Woodland Realm. Javelin throwers, obviously, but really good in melee, obviously, as well. So they're going to throw some javelins into the mountain trolls. Going to miss actually a lot of them. I'm actually surprised at that. Kind of did not expect that. But look at that. Just a few shots and absolutely destroy the mountain elf. I mean, the mountain trolls. A couple mountain trolls, obviously. Not all of them. Gonna try to run these guys out. Gonna try to run these guys away. And fire into some more trolls. Obviously, trolls are still really, really great in melee. And can take out quite a few units as they please. And I'm just gonna throw some more javelins into the mountain trolls. Try to take them down. Again, we could take down quite a few mountain trolls with just a few throws of the javelin. So while they're really, really, really amazingly strong, some javelins to the face will fix that right up. I'm just gonna try to charge. Killed both of them, and now it's only the general left. So now I'm just gonna run my Elder Council in and just proceed to wreck him.
Victory will be ours.
Fortunately, they don't do as much damage as the per javelin throw. So again, mountain trolls, excellent unit, absolutely great unit, but when faced with a few dozen javelins or even a few dozen arrows, especially if they're elven arrows, they're gonna get wrecked. Alright, I'm gonna go to the campaign map now. Alright, so I loaded into a campaign as Gondor, obviously, and I'm going to do toggle Fow to show you all the campaign map. Let's look at Gondor first. They're holding some of the initially they're holding a few cities in front of Mordor. Mordor with its giant mountains. The only ways in are through Morannon or / the Black Gate, Minas Morgul, but then you gotta go through Cirith Ungol. There's also a way through the back around here where it's being protected by Rune and the Varigs of Khand. Also, Harad and not Umbar. But so there's a lot of initially there's a lot of rebel cities. So you have relatively safe beginnings in just taking the few rebel cities that are around you, initially around you. A lot of them. There's so many of them. Like, if you look at the bottom left, you'll see that just in this, one right there, one right there, one right there, one right there. In this forest alone, there's about one, two, three, four, five, six, seven. I'd say about seven in just this large forest alone. There's a lot of rebel faction. I mean, a lot of rebel cities. So even if you're the elves with this is what Realm of Lothlorien starts with. These two right here, and tiny units. They can relatively expand relatively quick. Well, actually, not really. They're not really surrounded by anything much. But, anyways. So even Dolgoldor, we'll say. They could just take in Ostengel, Dor, Lingvar, so very, very nice beginning, very relatively easy starting for pretty much everyone. Everyone's nicely located. Gundabad, Goblin Town, the Orsimist Mountain. While they're spread out, they're still really strong because, you know, say you're besieging Goblin Town, an army from Zog-Kala can come up and attack you, or Zog-Kala. All of a sudden, an army from Goblin Town will come and attack you, and because Orcs in the Mist Mountains are very, 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 very fast at recruiting, you're about to die. So yes, some really, really nice factions as well. There's the Remnants of Angmar, Orcs in the Mist Mountains, the Valesmen, Vale of Anduin. It's more of a barbarian... human faction. Kind of a large one. Not really. Realm of the Gladrium, or Lothlorien, or whatever you want to call it. Realm of Imladris. Dunedain. The tiny Dunedain beginning, starting point. The sort of large Breeland. Free Peoples of Middle-earth. The Haven of Lindon. Which, in all honesty, the Lindon was one of the factions, it's really Lindon, Dol Amroth right here, and the Haven of Umbar, which is right here, who are the kings of the sea. Sure, Gondor can have some ships, maybe even Anedwaith, but it is those three, Lindon, Umbar, and... Dol Amroth that rule the sea. So, it's a nice Erdluin. clans of Enidwaith, the clans of the Dunlendings, Isengard, Rohan, even the Forest of Fangorn has its own faction. Obviously, Gondor is its own faction. Relatively weak, just because it's so big, and it kind of does have enemies. Like, sure, Isengard is right here. And so, Gondor has a few turns of being safe before both Enidwaith and Isengard reach it. Now, it also does have its ally, Rohan, right here, but they're going to be being attacked by Isengard as well. And don't forget, Gondor has to deal with Mordor. So, Gondor is in trouble. Let's just say that. Gondor's always in trouble. Plus, they're surrounded by Harad, Vergzikand, and Rune. Now, something that's funny. I never heard of Vergzikand. Alright. I kind of heard of Rune, but I only knew him as the Easterlings, or those guys that, during the Lord of the Rings movie at the scene of the Black Gate, those guys, I knew only as those guys. Harad, obviously, I knew the Mumakil, or the Oliphants. Never knew about, I knew about the Corsairs, didn't know that they were Umbar, I just thought that they were the bad guys. Really, that's it. And I never knew about these guys, the Vale of Dorwinion. Now, this is a very, very interesting faction, because it's both human and elves. You can choose whether or not you want to go with elves or human. Obviously, the humans are less expensive and less good, but more of them, while the elves are, well, elves. Very, very interesting faction. Dale, really good faction as well. A fairly good faction with Ezgaroth and Dale right next to Erebor, with the Dwarves of Erebor. Very nice faction. I love the dwarves. Dwarves are some of the best factions. I'm just a big dwarf fan, even though I do love playing as the elves, just because the elves are elves. Also, the Khazad-dûm. And the Khazad-dûm has something interesting about them. They're more legio. They're more legionized, I guess you could call it. And I like how Moria has been split into different, really different factions. No, Moria has been split into two separate holds. I think possibly the Bridge of Khazad-dûm is what you need. So, again, very huge campaign map. It's going to take you quite a long time to actually win. Like, if you want to color the campaign map your own color, it's going to take a long, long time. And by the time you're relatively powerful, everyone else is relatively powerful as well. So you got to deal with that, too. So, I'm actually going to go to the credits, and then I'm going to talk about the rest of what I want to talk about. So I'll see you at the credits. Alright, so let's view the credits. Everything goes to these guys. They made it. They are the boss. I'm actually going to also have, in the description down below, I'm going to have two links. One link is to the mod on, actually three links. One link is to the Divide and Conquer mod. Divide and Conquer mod. The second link is going to be to the Third Age mod, because with Divide and Conquer, it is a submod for the initial Third Age mod. So you'll have to like get the recent Third Age mod and then add Divide and Conquer to that. So I'm going to have those two links, and the third link is going to be a link to the leader of, I think he's the leader of the Divide and Conquer mod. I don't know his, I cannot pronounce his elven name, because it's elven. There's going to be a link to his YouTube channel, which he does a lot about this mod, so it's pretty much my whole Medieval Mod Mondays, that's his channel. Except for this mod, specifically. So, it's really cool. He goes through a lot of his different factions. Really interesting. You can learn a lot. Go check that out. So, I would give this mod a 10 out of 10. It is the absolute best mod that there is. It is my number one mod for Medieval 2 Total War. Just actually, you know what? Out of all the mods, of all the games I've played, this is the best mod. I love this more than, like, I would kill for a Total War that's... See, even if Creative Assembly did make a Third Age Total War, this mod would be better. This mod would be 1,000 times better. I absolutely love this mod. If you have noticed, I absolutely love this mod. It's such a great mod. Such a fantastic mod. So, Arrakir Galadriathon. Probably pronounced it wrong, but that was the leader. So, that's also the YouTube channel. So, those three links will be in the description. This is my number one mod. Best mod ever. Check it out. If you haven't played it, go check it out. If you don't have Medieval 2, wait. It's almost Black Friday. Buy it on Steam, along with Kingdoms DLC. Get this mod. Play it. It's absolutely fantastic. You need to really play it yourself to be able to get the whole feel of it. It's just a fantastic mod. I absolutely love it. Did I tell you I absolutely love it? I'm going to keep on repeating that. I adore this mod. Number one mod. 10 out of 10. IGN. Not Skyrim. And not with... Well, with it does have swords. So, this was This Mod Mondays. I hope you have enjoyed. I will see you next time, and goodbye.